So now we want to show you how to use the template for a user journey, as that can be kind of complex. But the first thing you do is to put in your situation, which we will, in this example, be get groceries for the week. What's important for the user journey is that you have a persona to work from or your user sitting with you to discuss how these steps are actually performed. So in this example, we're using a wheelchair user that likes technology. So the first step here would be to find out what they want for dinner for the week. And then you just go through all the different steps. Here we're gonna have a six-step process, but this is just a snippet of the whole journey. Because here we end up that they actually go shopping at the place that they want to go shop. But when you have the steps laid out, it's time to categorize them. So first thing you do is to figure out where is all the steps performed. So up until step four, we're just gonna put in the line, and this is at home. So the user is in this case doing all these steps at home. Going to the grocery store, they are on their way to the grocery store. And the last step, they are at the grocery store. This is just to figure out what their environment is. Then we can go a little bit deeper and ask ourselves, how are they then doing these steps? For example, in the first steps, they are asking their caretaker to note down a meal plan. Then you ask yourself, who are they interacting with? In this case, it is the caretaker. And then you can go even deeper and ask yourself, how are they, their emotion in these steps? And for the first step here, they can be happy because they have a person that they can spar with about their meal plan. But maybe for the second step, they would be annoyed because how they are actually going by doing this step, which is to check the fridge to see if anything is missing, is that they go to the kitchen and ask the caretaker to open the fridge because maybe they also have lost the ability to move their arms. So here they are annoyed because they actually want to be independent. And by doing these steps and going into the layers, you are not only getting an overview over what steps are you going through, but you can also pinpoint where the pain points are in the entire journey. So for example, when they're happy, this might not be the place to attack and come up with solutions to solve a problem. But in the second step, where they are annoyed because they want to be more independent, would maybe be a place where you would set in with your project. And that is how you use the user journey.